life for a life. And the third one, for the one who becomes renegade from his religion. So you say, ah, the ruler has judged by other than Allah has revealed. He's a kafir. So therefore, let's kill him, kill him and his family. He's buried in the graveyard of the kuffar. He doesn't inherit, and so on and so forth, causing bloodshed in the land, especially focusing upon the rulers, but also upon other than the rulers. So the people went to two extremes with regard to iman. Those who said that iman does not rise and fall, so the iman of the sinner, the oppressor, the one who, for example, the one who kills, the one who steals, the one who backbites, the one who lies, the one who fornicates, and other than that, from the various dhunub, from the various sins and the kabair, that the murji'ah said, that his iman is like the iman of Jibreel alayhi salam, the angel who descended with the revelation to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then the khawarij went to the other extreme. The khawarij were at the other extreme, even though the khawarij were the first ones to come. But the khawarij were at the other extreme. And they took the position that the one who commits a major sin, that the whole of iman has been stripped away from his heart altogether. So iman immediately is finished and nullified. In brief, that's the issue that he begins with, the first point. The second point that he brings, he said, and the Qur'an is the speech of Allah. It is not created due to his saying, meaning the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْعَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُبَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْأَرْشِ يُغْشِي لَيْلَ النَّحَارَ يَطْلُبُهُ حَثِيثًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ النَّجُومَ مُسَخَّرَاتٍ بِأَمْرِهِ. He says that indeed your Lord is Allah, who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. And then he made istiwa, he rose over his throne. He brings the night as a cover over the day, seeking it rapidly. And he created the sun, the moon, and the stars, subjugated to his command. And then Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Ismail said, Ibn Uyayna, the great imam of the second century, he said, so Allah made distinct the creation from the command. Allah made distinct. Allah mentioned the creation, and then he mentioned his command. And the command of Allah is what? Nothing other than his order and his speech, that which he commands. So Allah mentioned, made a distinction. He said in the remainder of the ayah, ala lahu al-khalqu wal-amru tabarakallahu rabbul alameen. That Allah said, surely his creation, the creation of Allah and the command of Allah. So Allah made a distinction between the creation and his command, showing that there is a creation of Allah and there is the command of Allah. And the command of Allah is not part of his creation. Rather, it's a part of his speech. Blessed be Allah, the Lord of Alameen, meaning the Lord of creation, or the Lord of all that exists. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Imam al-Bukhari, is mentioning another important matter. And that is that the Qur'an, it is the speech of Allah. It is the speech of Allah. Whether it is that which is recited upon the tongues, it is the speech of Allah. Whether it is that which is contained in the mushaf, it is the speech of Allah. Whether it is written in the lawhil mahfud, it is the speech of Allah. Whether it is put upon the slates of the children in the madaris of Quran, in the tahfiz of Quran, it is the speech of Allah. So in whatever form, it is the speech of Allah, and it is not created. And this is the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah with regard to the speech of Allah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ala lahul khalqu wal amru tabarakallahu rabbul alameen. That surely his is the creation, meaning the creation belongs to Allah, and his is the command. Distinct, creation is there and the command is there. So the command of Allah is nothing other than his speech, and it is distinct from the creation. Imam Ahmad Ibn Hanbal was asked about the one who says that the Quran is created. He said he is a kafir. He is a kafir. Imam al-Lalakai reports from Ahmad Ibn Abdullah Ibn al-Khidr, the al-Muqri, أبو محمد يحيى بن خلف المقرئ said, I was with Malik ibn Anas, the great Imam who died in the year 179 after the Hijrah. He said, I was with Malik ibn Anas, and a man came to him and he said, Ya Aba Abdullah, O Abu Abdullah, what do you say about the one who says that the Quran is created? He said, meaning Malik, a disbeliever, a murtad, or a zindir, kill him. The man then said, I am just quoting these words which I heard. Then Imam Malik said to him, I have not heard these from anyone else. I have only heard them from you. I have only heard them from you. So Abu Muhammad said, that was a bit tough upon me, or a bit hard for me. So I went to Egypt. So he left Medina. Then I met Ibn Lahiyah. And I said to him the equivalent of what I'd already said to Layth ibn Sa'ad and to Imam Malik. And I narrated him the words. He said, likewise, a kafir. And then in another narration from Abbas ibn Azhar, they continued. And then I came to Mecca. So where did he go? Medina, asked Malik. Went all the way to Egypt, asked Layth ibn Sa'ad. Then he came all the way back and went to Mecca. And I came to Mecca and I met Sufyan ibn Uyayna. Three great imams so far. And I narrated him to the word, narrated him the words of Imam Malik, of the man who came to Imam Malik. And he said, he is a disbeliever, likewise. And then I went to Kufa. So then now he's left Mecca and he's gone all the way to Iraq. He went all the way to Iraq. And I met Abu Bakr ibn Ayyash and I said to him, what do you say about the one who says that the Quran is created? And I narrated him to the words of the man. He said he is a disbeliever. And whoever does not say he is a disbeliever, then he himself is a disbeliever. And then I met Ali ibn Asim and Hashim. And I said to them both the same. And I narrated him the words of the man. And they both said a disbeliever. And then I went to Abdullah ibn Idris. And to Abu Usama. And to Ubda ibn Sulaiman al-Kallabi. And Yahya ibn Zakariya. And to Waqiyah. And I narrated to all of them, and all of them said to me, he's a disbeliever. And then I met Abdullah ibn Mubarak, and Abu Ishaq al-Fazari, and Al-Walid ibn Muslim. And I narrated to them the same words, and they all of them said to me, he's a disbeliever. Look at Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Look at the different lands that he's gone to. In a time when there's no telephone, in a time when there's no aeroplane, no cars, no trains. He's traveling to all of these a'imma of al-Islam. And he's met the best of them. The likes of them that you and I will never see unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to meet them on Yawmul Qiyamah. All of them with the same speech about the one who says that the Qur'an is created. And Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah ta'ala, said in Khalq Af'al al-Ibad, he said, Al-Hakam ibn Muhammad ibn al-Tabari, I wrote down from him in Mecca. And he said, Sufyan ibn Uyayna said, I have met with our sheikhs for 70 years. And amongst them was Amr ibn Dinar. And all of them said that the Quran is the speech of Allah, not created. So is there anyone in any doubts as to regard to the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah with regard to the Quran? No one should be in any doubt. Anyone who doubts that the Quran is the speech of Allah, then this person has fallen into major kufr. Has fallen into major kufr. Then Imam al-Bukhari mentions, he said, and the good and the evil is by the preordainment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the qadr of Allah. This is the third point. And the good and the evil is by the preordainment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Due to his saying, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ. That I say, I seek refuge with Allah from the Lord of the daybreak. مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ. From the evil of what he has created. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created what? Created the evil. From the evil of what he has created. Then he continues, وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَكُمْ وَمَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah created you and that which you make. Surah Safat, ayah number 96. And due to the saying of Allah,